never accepted it. I didn't know about bisexual. I never even heard the damn term. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel. If you're new, I really hope you're subscribed because I got a lot of videos coming up. Make sure you subscribe and turn that little bell on so you'll get notified when I post a new video. I honestly don't like telling people to subscribe, but I do it anyway because, hey, it's YouTube. So, anyway, I have an exciting video for you today. Well, it was more exciting for me than anyone else, but I'm going to talk about it because I've never fully explained what happened when I came out. Y'all, I believe I already did a video about how I realized that I was bisexual. If you did not see that, you need to go watch it. I already talked about how I realized I was bisexual, what was happening to me around that time, and my first woman crush. Like my first celebrity woman crush. I already talked about that. So if you don't know about that, you need to watch part one. This is pretty much like a part two of that. Because I said I was going to talk about how I came out to my husband and I did not. So I'm just going to do it right now because, hey, like I said, it's kind of like a fun concept. And a lot of people honestly want to know because a lot of people go through the same thing every damn day. And I guess they need advice or I guess just knowing that someone else has a similar issue, you know, as you is very helpful. That's always very helpful to know that you're not alone in what you're going through, you know? Yeah, we all feel that way. So I'm going to explain, like I said, how I came out to my husband. Now, if you've already watched the other video, then you know I was obsessed with Dej Loaf. Kind of funny because I don't give a shit about her now. You know, she's still cute and all, and I still love her voice, but I'm not anywhere near obsessed with her. That was a phase. Me being in love with her like that was a complete and total phase, and it was just like a period in time. You know how when you get a crush as a child, and you like them for that period of time, and then it kind of phases away, blah, blah, blah. I guess that's basically how it happened. So anyway, So I was being really, really infatuated with her at the time. And I remember I was really, this is like a point in life I was trying to figure myself out. Life was okay, you know, it was stressful monetarily, as always. But my husband and I were okay. I believe we were in good terms as far as our marriage. Things were going well. So this was nothing to do with him or anything he did that pushed me towards a woman. No, it was nothing that crazy. I just became obsessed with Dej Loaf. And my husband kind of realized it. He realized that I was into her a lot. And I remember one day, I think he came home from work. It was like afternoon, some random afternoon in the year 2014, whatever year I came out. Damn, I forgot. I need to relook that back up. The year I actually came out. I believe it was 2014. I'm not totally sure, but I believe it was 2014. Anyway, I did another video on this, which kind of led up to this issue, where I mentioned we were talking about polyamory prior to me realizing that I was bisexual. We were talking about, you know, possibly getting a second wife because this poly thing was getting big, you know, the whole polygamy in general was getting popular. And I saw a video from Goddess Aiyanna, if you guys don't know her, and she's a YouTuber, like a, what do you call it, a woke YouTuber, you know, conscious, you know, that type of thing. She's into those type of things. So when she first went viral, her video was about polygamy, and I remember watching it. Me and my husband watched it at first, and at first we were like, whoa, no way. There's no way, you know, we can get a second wife. There's no way I would do that. I said that at first. And a few months later, you know, I kept revisiting the idea because I'm sitting there like, okay, what would be so bad? You know what I mean? I'm not really a jealous person. I never saw myself to be the type of woman that would get jealous if my husband was with another woman. I never really saw myself that way, so I had to really, really think about it. So again, with me thinking about it, we kind of accepted it, like, okay, well, maybe this isn't a bad idea. You know, I'm lonely anyway. I could use some help with the kids. You know, I could use some, you know, some woman energies around, because I don't have any. I don't have any friends and all that stuff. That's what was going on with me at the time. And so we said, cool, okay, well, if this works, well, we'll try it. Maybe if a woman comes along, you know, we'll try it. See where it goes. So after we decided on that, technically that's when I started noticing deja loaf. I don't know why. I don't think it has any correlation with that. But either way, I was, I didn't know. Meanwhile, I didn't really accept me being into women sexually. I was nowhere near thinking about that at the time we accepted polyamory. So that was nowhere in the cards. None of that was anywhere in the cards until deja loaf came along. So basically, back to the beginning, when deja loaf came along, like I said, my husband came home from work one day. I forgot what I was telling him. I was scared as fuck to tell him that I was interested in deja loaf like that. I was scared because if you guys remember any of my old videos, then you know that I was attracted to women way back in college. But neither him nor I knew about bisexuality then. We didn't know. I was attracted to women in college. I used to like point out women, you know, as a joke or whatever, but we both just fluffed it off to say, okay, well, you're not gay, so you must be straight. We fluffed it off, so I never accepted it. I didn't know about bisexuality. I never even heard the damn term. So again, I was scared to tell him, but I told him like in a joking way. Like, I told him, I was like, okay, well, I kind of feeling for somebody. I'm kind of crushing on somebody right now. And you know, he was laughing, kind of like in a laughing tone. He was like, oh, who? What was it? I think he was like, well, who is he? Or something like that. Of course, he automatically thought it was a man. And we were just kind of touching along that topic prior to, like a few days before, like kind of joking, like, you know, oh, well, that's your boyfriend, you know, I know you like him or whatever, even though I don't really joke like that too much. There's not many men that get my attention, but either way, he thought, he was just laughing, like, okay, well, who is he? You know, tell me. He thought it was just some celebrity, because there's no other man in my life, frankly. So yeah, I was very, 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 very shy. I remember I was sitting there on the bed like, damn, do I tell him? Should I tell him? Should I tell him? You know, I didn't want to tell him. I legit thought he was going to leave me. I thought my man was going to leave me when I told him that I had feelings for another woman. But I told him slowly. I was like, well, it's not exactly a he. And he was like, what are you talking about? And I was like, well, kind of crushing on deja loaf. And he knew who deja loaf was because, again, I had been talking about her for like how many fucking weeks at the time. He heard a little bit of her music, even though he's not into that type of music. But he heard it anyway through me because, I kept talking about her. So I told him, and he was just like, He was a little stoned at first, but he kind of laughed it off. It was more like a laughing, like, it was more like a joke. I think he thought I was joking. Like, he was like, okay, but she's a woman. And I was like, yeah, I know, but I think I have a crush on her. But that's just how I feel at the moment. And he was like, wow, no wonder you've been into her so much. You know, you wonder, it was something like that. He was like, wow, I have noticed you've been into her a lot, but not like, I never thought of it like that. And y'all, I was sitting there like practically dripping sweat, heart pounding, because I didn't know what was going to happen. And like I said, he laughed it off at first. He didn't take it very seriously, but I don't think we talked about it much for the rest of that day. But the next day, y'all, shit hit the fan. It was no longer a joke. Like, the reality caught up. The reality had caught up to both of us. Like, okay, I have accepted this. I didn't want to label myself. By the way, I hadn't said anything about labeling myself. I just said I had a crush on Azulf. And me telling him was like a first step for me to accepting how I was feeling. And it was just like, whoa. It was like pow in his face. Like I said, it didn't really hit him until the next day. So the next day he was kind of angry. And, well, not like super angry, but he had a lot of questions, quite naturally. And it was kind of overwhelming, you know. But I don't really mind talking about these things because I'm open. Me and my husband, we have an extremely open relationship. We tell each other, like, everything. So I didn't mind telling him exactly how I was feeling. I didn't mind telling him why I was feeling this way. I didn't mind telling him the nitty-gritty of, you know, what led up to it. You know, I didn't mind telling him why I liked her or any of that. So I just told him what I could. And I told him, okay, yeah, I think I like women now, but that doesn't mean I want to leave you. Y'all, that was not hitting home. Like, it's just like, the reality that your wife is now into women was just mind-boggling. I expected that. I kind of expected that because after doing my research, after all these years, there are many women who go through the same thing. Many couples who end up the same way. There are a lot of women who know they're bi prior to getting married, and they're lucky enough to tell their man before they get married. And, you know, it was up to the man whether he wants to accept them or not. But me, I wasn't so lucky. Like I said, I didn't know shit about sexuality. I knew shit about bisexuality. I didn't know it existed. I didn't know anything. So I was just left to accept this within, like, what was it, the 7th year of my marriage? 7th or 8th, something like that. So yeah, it's a little overwhelming. It was very overwhelming for him. Like I said, he had a lot of questions. Things got heated a couple of times. He really thought I was gonna leave him. And I took every piece of, every fiber of my being to convince him that no, I'm not leaving. I don't want to leave you to be with a woman. I just like women. I guess I like women now. More so, I was accepting that I liked women because I had always liked women. I didn't accept it. This was way back when I was still in the Christian mindset. When we first got married, I was putting down all that stuff. I didn't really point out women anymore like I used to in college, even though I still thought women was attractive, but I never talked about it. I never openly talked about it with him. I never told anyone after that. It was just, okay, we're married now. I want to stop, you know, looking at women like this. But like I said, it hit me like a ton of bricks around that time in our marriage, and it was just kind of a mess. It wasn't like super easy. Nothing was hunky-dory. Like I said, a lot of questions, a lot of battles, a lot of scenarios, a lot of research on his part. And he had to do a lot of research, and I had to do a lot of research, and we had to just battle it out for a while. And that's honestly how it was. I'm not going to sit here and sugarcoat and tell you everything was okay, because no, it sure was a fucking hell, wasn't it? It was not always easy. This road of coming out to him was not always easy. Now, I will tell you, it's great that he finally accepted me, because I honestly thought he was going to leave me. I really did. Like, you know, we've been through a lot of shit in our marriage. A lot of shit regarding the abuse, what the abuse has done to me. My family has done to me, what his family has done to him. We've just been through a lot, and I thought that was just the final straw for him. I thought he was just gonna be like, you know what, I can't take this. Just, you want a woman? Go ahead and get one. I'm out. But no, he stuck around. And it has not been easy, like I said, but he's still working with me. And I really appreciate that. Because a lot of women in my position do not get so lucky. There are a lot of married women who randomly come out as bi and their husbands can't take it. Like, they literally don't even blink an eye. It's just like, oh wow, okay, shit, bi. Some men are not as understanding. So I'm kind of lucky. I'm lucky that he's still here, and we're even looking for a wife. together, you know, preferably getting one together. Yeah, that's that. That's how I came out to my husband. Did I miss anything? I feel like I'm missing a big detail. But I don't know what it is. Damn, what's another juicy detail? Oh, yeah, the juiciest detail. I wasn't sure if I was going to even say this, but, come closer. Me coming out has made me actually want to role play in bed, if you know what I mean. Yeah. Me coming out has, it's opened my sexuality up in a whole new way that I didn't even know existed. I thought I was a freak then. Now, yeah. Now I have all the energy in the world as I used to because, of course, 5 kids and, you know, my body ain't the same, but me coming out has made me, it's made my sexuality way more heightened. It's opened up my body to like, I mean, all this time I kind of figured I was missing something. I've always had that feeling that I was missing something. And it wasn't like, again, it wasn't my husband's fault. It wasn't anything he was doing wrong because, no, we have no sexual problems in that area. Like, none. Our sex life has always been great, like massively great. But when I came out, oh my God. Our sex life took a turn for the better. I had more energy, more of this, more of that. And me just thinking about Dave's loaf in bed just turned me way the hell on. Like, it did wonders. Yo, I can't even explain. I can't do certain stuff I'm not gonna put up here, but there are many, many ways it enhanced my sex life. And I never thought that would happen. I never thought my sex life could be even more enhanced. If you know what I mean. We all know the monotony of marriage life gets to us. But, yo, I can't express enough how it opened me up. Like I said, I always knew something was missing in my sex life and probably, like, emotionally also. But when I realized and accepted that I liked women and I finally came to terms with it instead of, like, saying, okay, this can't be true, and I'm rehashing it in my head, yet every day I'm waking up with the same feeling, and until I finally accepted that, I just wasn't getting what I needed in certain ways. And like I said, I knew I was missing something. I just didn't know what the fuck it was until I came out. Then it opened a huge door. Like I said, role playing in bed. That's all I'm gonna say. Trying to get too deep into that, but thinking about a woman in bed, aka threesome, blew things up. So yeah, in a good way. Now, yeah, I hope to experience it in real life at some point, sometime this lifetime. So yeah, I think I talked enough. I hope I didn't leave out anything. If you think I did, let me know in the comment box. I hope this video was pretty entertaining for you. Write what you think in the comment box. Tell me your opinions, your experiences, your thoughts, your all of that. Let me know in the comment box below and I will chat with you. And again, I hope you're subscribed and I hope you turn that bell on. Turn on that damn bell. I'm still getting a massive load of subscribers. I'm so proud of you guys. Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So that's all I've got for you guys. Hope you guys are having a great day, month, year, century, all of that jazz. And thank you for watching. Peace out.